Hello and welcome back to ExpoHub channel, myself Rakesh, and today our topic is how will you extract the confidence score? Extraction of confidence score, what is the confidence score in document understanding we are going to learn? Okay, so confidence score, let me show you. Here is the document understanding workflow and I have already run this project, and let me first show you what is the confidence score. I am just pulling it for the invoice. Okay, so once you extract the data, you can see these are the different data which I have extracted for the invoice, and beside each field there is something called confidence. Okay, do you know how to pull this confidence score? Will you be able to write one Excel sheet? Because this is going to help me whether the data is correct. Let's say it is 20%, 10%, that means something inaccurate data has come to my Excel sheet, right? This is going to help me to determine if anything below 20%, below 50%. So depending on your threshold, you can always determine. So sometimes if you have already done this kind of a job, sometimes you might find a one beside each field, there is a 111. So those one is nothing but they are 100%. If it is written 0.994, right, that means it is 94%, 97% accurate, 61% accurate, 96% accurate, right? So how will you get this confidence score? Let's learn it. Okay, let's learn it. So first of all, let me tell you two different things. You have gone through the entire workflow, digitization, classification and all that. Okay, now here in the data extraction step, there is a very important variable that comes out. Okay, what is that variable name? Do you remember? The output of the data extraction step. Okay, output of data extraction step. So we generally give the name extraction results. So it could be any variable, but again the output, the extraction result variable, right? This is such an important variable which contains your confidence score, because in the data extraction scope you are using some kind of extractor and you are extracting the data. And after you extract, it also gives you a confidence score, you know, how confident it is with the data that it has pulled. So how do you exercise with that confidence score? I'm going to literally show you. Okay, now for that, let's get started. Very simple activity. Let's drag and drop write to text below the data extraction step. However your flow looks like, doesn't matter. It may not look like I have designed, it may be slightly different, doesn't matter. Just drag and drop write text to file below the data extraction step. Okay, so once you do this, the output of your data extraction step, right, use that and say dot serialize. That means I am going to convert that object into a text format. Okay, so I'm going to serialize that output and then let's write it to a file. So click on this, go to document processing, and here let me say I'm creating a new text file where it's going to write that output. Okay, confidence score, and save it. Simple. So now it is going to write it into this file. Now let me first run it and show you the output. Okay, let's run it. So let's run it to save a little time. Okay, okay, let's wait for a minute. Okay, digitization started. So if you need this output panel on the right hand side, you can just drag and drop it. Okay, extracting data from the document. Okay, it's in the extraction step. Okay, now it has opened the validation station. So I am okay with all the data. I'll just save it. So our main objective is to look at the text file, right? So let's go to our project and open that specific file that we have created. Confidence score, where is it? Okay, so let's open this. Just refresh, okay, in case you do not see it. Let me use a notepad. Alright, so now if you see the entire extraction result variable, see it contains so much of data. Do you see? So much of data it contains. Now we are interested in the confidence score. Okay, so you have to clearly go through this because there are a lot of data. So first, what is our first field? Invoice number, right? If you see, here is the field name. Okay, here is the field name, invoice, and then next field name is invoice date. So I'm just separating it. Okay, now if you look invoice number, there is something called confidence score, 0.94. that means 94% confident it is with the data. Similar way, if you look at the invoice date, let me separate this. If you see the invoice date field, it has a confidence score of 0.97, which is nothing but 97%. Okay, so this is the this may be a very first time you are seeing the data. Now the question here is, how do you write this confidence scores, right? So this is very simple. All I am doing while I am writing the data in the export extraction results, right, where you write the data, you are exporting the data to a data set, and then after the data set you are writing it to a Excel file. So while you are writing, if you look at my export extraction step, instead of me using the validated extraction result output, I am using the extraction results output from the data extraction step. Okay, now if you open your Excel file where you are writing this output to, okay, all this I have taught in the previous videos. Okay, I'm pretty sure you must have, you are aware in some way. So now if I open this, okay, if I open this, you will see all this exact scores as it was there in this notepad. The same scores has been updated. Okay, confidence score, for example, invoice number, confidence score is 94. Just now we saw that, right? Invoice number, the confidence score is 94, right? Exact number has been already written. So this gives you a determination point. I mean you can determine whether this data is accurate or not. Okay, so even if you are not using a validation step, just by having this Excel file, you can filter out if something is lower than that, then you can probably try to recheck that particular invoice. Some data is not accurate, you can manually do it. Okay, so that gives you a human validation process. So this is one way. Okay, there are several ways one can develop. Now let's say I want to use the validation step. Okay, let me close this. Okay, now let's go back, and instead of, let's minimize all of this. Okay, otherwise one would easily get confused. So let's minimize. Okay, so instead of me writing under the data extraction step, what if I drag and post it here below the validation step? Okay, so here is the validation step. If you see, right, validation step. So below this particular activity, I am using write text, and instead of using extraction results, let me use what is the output of the validation step? Validation result, extraction results. Okay, so I'm using this particular variable, and I'm going to do the same process dot serialize. Okay, dot serialize. Now what would happen, whatever the way we are validating in the present validation station, depending on that particular score would come to your output. So let me show you that. Okay, let's quickly run it. Okay, one second. So one more change you have to do, right? What is the change? So after you do, after you write this, also you have to use the same for the export extraction. So here we have used extraction results, right? Let's use validated validated extraction results. Okay, I'm using this variable now. So let's see what kind of output comes now. Getting it? So let's save it and let's run the file. So let me close this Excel file in the background. Okay, so the processing has started. So there will be a big difference, okay, because now what would happen, we are using validated extraction result variable to export the data from. Okay, so what would happen, you are validating in the personal, so everything you are marking, right? The moment you mark, what happens, it gets 100% score. So in your Excel sheet you will find 11111. That means you have used a personal validation station. Okay, that is the indication. So now the personal validation station has come, Now, let's say I am happy with the data. Yes, it's accurate. This is also accurate. This is also accurate. So you are giving. So what is happening? The moment you select this, that means you are giving your thumbs up. Yeah, I am fine with the data. So it is marking itself as 100%. Okay. So I am happy with all the data. Okay, I'm fine. Okay, I'm done with all the data. So 100% everything is marked safe. So now what would happen when you see this output, and we'll also open the confidence score. I'm going to show you both of you. So let me open this notepad always. Okay. So now if you open this, let's look for the field name. Okay, field ID. Okay, field. Okay, so if we separate this, okay, so now if you see, the confidence score is marked as 1.0 for invoice, even for this one. Let's separate, right? If you see, the confidence score is different. So the for the first one, the confidence score is 1.0. Where is the second one? I think below here. I did not do it properly. Okay, so confidence score is here also marked as 1.0. Now let's open the sheet, the output sheet. Okay, if you open the output sheet, even there in the output sheet, you would find the confidence score everywhere. It is marked as 1. Why it is 1? That means you are using a personal validation station. Getting it? So this columns are nothing but the confidence score. So this this is a great knowledge. If you have gone through this video, I'm pretty sure this would help you if this kind of a question is thrown at you in your interview. So you are pretty aware how to play with the confidence score. So thank you so much guys for watching it. We are going to come up with more knowledgeable videos, and my goal is that you have that clear-cut knowledge, in-depth knowledge, so that you are confident wherever you go. Okay, that's my goal. So thank you so much for connecting with ExpoHub channel. Please do like and subscribe to our channel. Please let your friends know to connect with our channel. Thank you guys. With that, we will connect again in the next video. Take care. Bye-bye.